好，听完球员访问，接下来听球评的见解，来听他们分析总冠军赛的 Game Four 有哪些看点。
没有错，而除了场上的专业分析以外，也要来看看球评点出塞尔提克听牌，只要维持前三战的节奏，是很有可能四战顺利封王。反观背水一战的独行侠，有哪些细微的逆转机会要好好把握？马上来看看。
总冠军赛第四战开打前夕，带着3-0绝对领先的塞尔提克，距离让他们成为 NBA 史上最多冠队伍的队史第18座金杯，只差一场胜利。而回顾前三场比赛，绿衫军能完胜的关键，就是在进攻端完全碾压了独行侠。不管是场均106分，比下独行侠的95.3，投篮三位命中率统统胜出，助攻数更整整多出对手11次。要是冷冰冰的数据不够有感觉，这边还有几段精华影片。
No wasted action. They take advantage of pick and rolls. They take advantage of opportunities. They understand the mismatch. Right here, see Kyrie is on the ball. He's doing the best job he can, but they're switching. On that switch, Derek Jones need to impact Derek White. Disrupt the pass. Stop it right there.Pressure the ball. Jalen has a clear advance pass to Jason in the paint. And the weak side in your gaps, you got to use your wingspan. They measure it for a reason when you go to the combine.
Yes.
If you don't use it, that means the pass can move. We call these rhythm passes. And when you close out to Jalen Brown, you know he's a right-hand driver. Switch your feet, send him left to the high lift help with Kyrie. Because if not, you put Jalen in his rhythm. When Jalen gets into his rhythm going right,
球评的分析，简单来说，就是塞尔提克把握了每个具有优势的进攻项目，像是身材有优势，就专注于大打小的打点；外线命中率有优势，就专注于球流动后的三分空档。就连Jaylen Brown都知道自己是右手，值3亿美金，而不是左手，那就专注于右手发动的单打。这样听起来，难道独行侠就没希望了吗？也不尽然。就拿第三战的第四节，那波20-2的攻势来举例，打出好的防守反击，就能创造奇迹。
They were using Boston's bad offense and converting it to their good offense. Great defense by Kyrie Irving forces Tatum into a tough shot, which again gives Dallas a chance to get the rebound. Luka gets out in transition, semi-break.Now watch Luka attacks the basket, gets to the paint, finds a wide open Green who knocks down the three. Again, Tatum forces a tough shot against Lively, gets the rebound. Luka gets his head up and a semi-break. He doesn't push it fast, but look, again, he attacks the paint, sucks Al Horford in. Again, PJ Washington gets a second good wide open three from the corner.
从这几个片段就能看出来，过去连三战得分没破百的独行侠，想续命的话，势必得做好防守端。理由很简单，只有手下对手才能在立足未稳之际，创造出他们擅长的进攻模式。而究竟背水一战的 Game Four， 他们能不能复制好的经验？球迷们锁定转播，一起看下去吧。
好，细节很重要，心态更是如此。像是目前绝对领先的塞尔提克，双 J 在赛前就是保持着成熟的态度，严阵以待。
没有错，而同样挺过磨难还有苦练的，还有总教练 Joe Mazzulla， 在去年紧急接掌兵符之后，短短2年时间，就有机会率队登顶。有一部分是要归功于他有一点偏执的个性。
俗话说得好，时势造英雄。但若没有经历过一番挫折低潮，就算局势再怎么完美，获得机会的人也终将是凡夫俗子。像是去年赛季从塞尔提克助理教练紧急扶正接掌兵符的 Joe Mazzulla， 若是第四战能够再度挥军进犯达拉斯顺利赢球，将以短短2年的时间就率队登顶。除了未来联盟教头排行榜上这位新生代名将的窜起之势会更加惊人以外，他有些病态偏执的带兵风格，也会在冠军金杯的点缀下获得最高肯定。
Favorite Joe Mazzulla quote. He won Coach of the Month, and I was like, "Hey, congratulations." He just looked at me and said, "Nobody cares."
2011年球员选秀落选，随即转任大学教练。经过10多年的苦练，Mazzulla有机会在冠军教练的名单上写下自己的名字。然而，成功的表面看似多么光荣，背后就注定有多少失败的痛苦磨难。关于这一点，阵中的双 J 连线肯定很有共鸣。2017年进入联盟搭档后，每年外界都在喊拆，但他们卧薪尝胆，历经了2022年冠军战中连输3场的挫折，2023年季后赛被热火燎原的逆袭，总算在今年以更成熟的心态、更坚毅的决心走向巅峰。
From our experiences over the past couple of years, the thing that we've really have gotten a lot better at is
not relaxing, not being complacent. From game to game or series to series, we always like want more.
Last year, just falling short on your home floor, it definitely hurt. And it was embarrassing, in my opinion. The team was relying on me. I mean, JT got hurt in game seven. Dropped the ball, so drove me all summer, drove me crazy.
除了过去失败的经验历历在目以外，参与2016年1-3大逆转的凯瑞·厄文也是他们无法松懈的一大原因。因为经历过大战的 Uncle Drew 最清楚要用什么样的心态在决定时刻带领球队。
2016, although we like to bring it up, was one of the toughest series that you'll probably ever see in basketball in general. I don't know if, you know, those records are just gonna, you know. Be so easy for someone just to look at and be like, yeah, we're able to do it too. But that belief should never die that you can win a series and win it together. But yeah, my message is, you know, to him, it's just he's not alone in this.
纵使 NBA 历史上过去的案例告诉我们，3-0就等于宣判死刑。纵使 Porzingis 有机会第四战复出上场，但球终究是圆的，抵达终点线前都还有变数。更不用说独行侠关键的 Game Four 依旧是在达拉斯主场进行。赛季存亡之际，都迷肯定毛起来欢呼，给予全部能量力挺球队。因此，这 NBA 总冠军赛的第四战还很难说。
好，同样是球星来看到卢卡·东契奇，其实在第三战之后有接受专访，而他坦言是有点自责。
没有错，但自责归自责，在专访过程中，卢卡·东契奇还是坚信独行侠是有机会在0-3落后的情况下创造历史。
Now that you've had a chance to sleep on it, reflect on it a little bit, how do you reflect on fouling out for the first time in your playoff career?
Yeah, it was tough. Probably wasn't the smartest thing. Just, you know, it was a physical game. To get 6 fouls, I didn't expect it.
You're the ultimate competitor. I'm sure you wanted to be out on the floor. How did it feel watching your teammates have to battle without you when the game was within reach for those final 4 minutes?
It's tough. I always say, you know, it's easier to be in a game than being on the bench. I was more nervous on the bench.
Do you feel like if you had been in the game, the outcome could have been different?
I mean, I feel, yeah, but, you know, I have trust in my teammates. I think we played some good possession. I have believed that we're going to win the game. Obviously, having me out there, you know, helps Kyrie a little bit more. So obviously, I think it will be a different outcome, but you never know.
So Kyrie said after the game, you know, what did you say to Luka? And he said at this point, you just kind of have to give him a hug and tell him it's okay. But did you feel like you let your teammates down?
Yeah, of course. I mean, like I say, you know, it wasn't the smartest thing to do, especially in this situation. It's the finals. You gotta give everything. You know, a little tired out there. But yeah, you know, Kyrie's been great for me, just having him on here.
So what did you say to your teammates afterwards?
It's my bad. You know, can't do that, especially in the NBA finals. You know, regular season is a little bit different, but can't really do that in the finals.
Yeah. To be fair, though, I mean, you guys did figure something out towards the end of the game. It's just hard to dig yourselves out of a 20-point hole. What did you find towards the end that you feel like you can build on moving forward?
I think we're having fun. We're playing our basketball. That's what we do. We got stops. We ran with pace. And that's kind of how we play the whole playoffs, you know, outside 1-2 games before the finals. So just having fun out there. We kind of forgot to have fun. Mm.
You have been dealing with a mountain of different ailments that continue to pile on. How are you feeling now?
100%.
You always say that.
I mean, it's just no excuses. I never have excuses. I know it's a lot. A lot of people are banged up. You know, just at the end of the day, it's a lot of games to play.
Do you feel like you still have another level that you can reach even with being this banged up?
Yeah, especially, you know, helping my teammates out. You know, they played a different kind of defense we've never seen before in these playoffs. You know, just let us go one-on-one. So I think I have to help out my teammates more.
Your defense has been under a lot of scrutiny, maybe because you're hurt, maybe because of something else. Do you feel like you can help your teammates more? Do you think the scrutiny you're under is fair?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, they're always going to talk about it, but at the end of the day, I don't think the biggest problem is our defense at this point. I think we scored 3 games under 100 points. I mean, that gives credit to Boston's defense. but I think our offense is a little bit more problematic right now than defense. Like I say, you know, we never scored three times in a row on the 100 points, especially with me and Kai out there. So that gives Boston defense a big credit. So I think we got to do a better job with that. And like I said, on 20 points, we got to play with a little more pace.
I know you said you're 100%, but do you expect to get another pain-killing shot before game four?
It's for Karras. Probably, yeah.
A team has never come back from an 0-3 deficit. You know that. You said that you have to have belief. Why do you have belief in this team that you can be the first?
Because we've been through a lot. We've only been together for 5 months. It was a moment in the regular season when we lost like 5-6 in a row. And, you know, from there we just went up. And I believe we can do it because of teammates I have and the whole team. We have great chemistry. We're going to stay together no matter what.